Around the World with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Kantor here at ACTRIMS 2018. I'm standing in front of a poster that I was an author on, and my co-authors were actually people with multiple sclerosis. And what we did is we said, listen, several years ago in about 2013, they came out with new research criteria for defining progressive MS and relapsing MS. The question is that criteria used by people with multiple sclerosis? What's been really interesting to me here at the poster session, and one of the advantages of doing a poster at a scientific meeting, is you get to talk to other people, other scientists who have perspective. And some of them have been saying, it's not only that it's confusing for people with MS, the new criteria are confusing for me as a clinician, or as a scientist, or as a researcher. And then they say, well, what's your solution? And my answer is, well, the new criteria and the new way we define progression of MS can be confusing to people with MS. It can make people with MS feel like, well, I'm not sure if I'm going to be taking off my disease-modifying therapy. Does this mean that I'm different than I was before? What does this mean for the future? And our solution isn't to, once again, from the top down, tell everybody what terminology we should use. It's actually an invitation. It's an invitation that people with multiple sclerosis and doctors who care for people with multiple sclerosis should sit down together and come up with common language to discuss all aspects and the full spectrum of multiple sclerosis. It's by doing that that we're going to be able to share information much better. It's not going to be confusing when you go on the web and you read about a way that MS is defined and you're like, well, that's not how my doctor talks to me about it. We'll be able to use common language in order to have the common goal. And our common goal is always to make you better. Thank you for joining.